Hello students, I am Ishan Trivedi, welcome you in the video lecture series. Today again I am going to discuss about the example based on model split analysis. First we are going to understand the problem statement and later we will have the solution based on the problem. The design year total person trips between four zones distributed in an OD matrix. It is in the table form. Here you can see the interzonal trips by person, or means total number of persons which are distributed in the OD matrix. The model split shows that the 65 by 35 private car versus the public transport as overall split. Means in a simple word, out of 100 trips, 65 trips were done by the cars and the 35 were done by the public transportation. So based on that we have to compute the model split. Here the another data is that the peak period occupancy are 2.1 persons per car and 49 persons per bus. If the goods vehicle constitute about 21% to the total trips which developed, then find the, or you can say develop the trip matrix for two modes. So here again, out of 100 trips, for example, 65 were done by the private car and 35 were done by the public transportation. Here the occupancy is given for both the transport. Here average 2.1% are traveling by car and 49% are traveling by a single bus. Means the persons which are traveling by car or by bus, means if between A to B zone there are 500 passengers which are using a public transport, then I am going to compute that how many buses are required to transport these 500 passengers. This is the example and that is what we are going to compute here. So the car trips are the design year total person trips into 65% upon the occupancy class. Means here whatever the design total person trips is been given, that is A to B, that is 1688. Out of the 1688, the 65% of people are using private car and their car occupancy is 2.1. So I have just cumulative way, I have just put it in a one frame and in one equation. And that's why I have formed to find out the number of car trips. So means out of 100 passengers, 65 passengers are using car, then what about 1688? Then the answer is simple. But out of that answer, if one car carries an average 2.1 passenger, then what about the rest of one? So I have just simplified those things here. And what I'm going to do, design your total person trips into 0.65 upon 2.1, and the answer is 0.309. Means this matrix value or matrix cell value into 0.309 will give me the total car trips. Similarly for bus trip, the design year total trips or total person trips into 35% upon 49, means out of 100 passengers or 100 persons, only 35 passengers or persons are using public transport. And what is the capacity of that bus, or you can say occupancy, that is 49 passengers. So in a single equation I have put both those things and the answer is the design year total person trips into 0.0071. So in that matrix value I'll just multiply with the 0.007 value and I'll get the total bus trips. So I'm going to make two matrix for car and bus individually. Then the third matrix will be the summation of both the bus and car trips. The later we will compute the goods vehicle contribution to overall trips, and finally we are going to develop final matrix. So let us first make this matrix for the car. Here we have the origin and destination zone, and for car trips, what I am going to use, I am going to use the factor 309, or means, so for this OD matrix, which factor I am going to use, and it is 0.309. So here each cell value will be multiplied with the 0.309 value, and I will get the number of car trips. So here for A2A zone there is no trips, so I won't get any car trips. For A2B zone, the total persons are 1688 and the factor is 0.309, so the nearest answer is 522. Similarly, for C and D, you can compute easily. For B zone, there is B2A activity and the number of persons are 280. Again, the factor is 0.309 and the nearest answer is 86. Similarly, you can compute for the BCD zone. For C zone, again, the C2A activities or persons are 410. The factor is 0.309 and the nearest answer is 127. Similarly, you can compute for the BCD. And at last, for D, again, the D2A activities or number of passengers are 190 and the factor is again 0.309. The nearest answer is 59. And similarly, you can calculate for the rest of the interzonal person trips. And so finally, I have computed the number of cars which are used in this journey. Similarly, I'll go with the bus and bus trips in the design year. So again, we have the same value, that is from origin to destination and origin zone to destination zone. And by putting the factor, that is 0.0071 for each cell value, and I'll compute the nearest value here. 1688 into 0.007 and the number of buses are 12. Similarly, you can calculate for the C and D destination. For B origin, we have the value 280 into 0.0071 and the answer is nearly 2. So, 2 number of bus require for B2A zone activity. Similarly, you can compute for the B, C and D zone. Now for C zone, again 410 persons trips are there and the factor is again 0.0071 and the number of buses which require for this, it is 3. Similarly, you can compute for the rest of the interzonal activity. For D zone, again the value is 190 and the factor is 0.0071, the number of buses required is 1. So this is how you can compute and form a bus trip design your matrix. Now what I am going to make, I am going to make the summation of all these and I will get the final matrix that denotes the car trips plus bus trips. So I am just going to make the summation for all those activities. So here the summation of A rows and B columns. So here I am going to make the summation of A's origin and A destination, A origin and B destination for car and bus respectively. So this is how you can do the similar things. So here for A origin to B destination, the number of car trips are 522 and for similarly for bus trips it is 12. So I'll just make the summation, that is 522 plus 12 and the answer is 534. Similarly, you can do for the entire matrix and find out the answer. It is one of the simplest thing and easiest to do, so that you can put the suitable cell value and make those summation and put it at the correct cell value. Now what we have in addition, that the goods vehicle are contributing 21% more, means if the ratio between these trips are 100, and out of 100 there are 21% trips addition in the form of goods vehicle. Means 65% of trips were in the form of cars, 35 trips were in the form of bus, and additional 21 trips are used as a goods vehicle. So the total trips which are generated by cars and bus plus that is 100% plus 21% additional trips are there. So for making those trip metrics which we have computed by the summation of car trips and bus trip, I am going to add one more factor, and that is goods trip. So final matrix is equal to matrix of the summation of car and bus into, I am going to add in those 100%. So 1 plus 21 divided by 100, that is additional 21% in that 100%. So it is 1 plus 21 upon 100. So the matrix by car and bus into 1.21. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just multiply whatever I have computed in the car plus bus matrix, and just multiply 1.21 value with those cell values. And the answer for the matrix A is, A2A there were no trips, so 0. For B, it is 534 into 1.21, and the nearest answer is 646. So total number of vehicles are, that includes car, bus and goods vehicle. And for A to B journey, it is 646. From A to C journey, it is 124 into 1.21, and the answer is nearly 150 number of vehicles. Then for D, it is 626 into 1.21, and the nearest answer is 757. Similarly, you can compute for the B origin and the respective zone destination, C origin and the respective zone destination, and at last for D zone and the respective destination of zones. So this is our final answer for all the modes of transport, and this is what the modal split analysis for different categories of vehicle. I'm ending this session here. I hope you have learned from this different type of example of modal split analysis. Thanks for watching this video.